11.28. Okay, you have to use higher decimal places. And now what about D4? Okay, 7.97. So that is what we got. Okay, so now we have to divide into three equal lengths. Okay, total length is 1 meter, so each length will be 1/3 meter. Okay, so this is of total length. Okay, so now what is the challenge? That I need to find D2 bar, I need to find D3 bar. Okay, so first thing is to find gradient. So gradient will be equal to D1 bar minus D4 bar by total length, which is 1000 mm. Okay, so that will be 11.28 minus 7.97 divided by 1000. This is how I am going to get a gradient. Now how do you get D2? D2 bar will be equal to D1 bar minus gradient into length of that particular element 1. So that will be equal to 11.28. okay, gradient you can calculate, and length of the element is 1/3 into 1000 mm. okay, because L value is 1000, so from this you are going to get D2. And how do I get D3? It will be D2 bar minus G into length of element 2. Okay, so you can get the value of D2 bar and you can put down and try to get this one. And to verify this, you can also get a D4 bar. Okay, how do I get D3 bar minus gradient into length of element 3. Okay, so length of element 3 is also 1/3 into 1000, so all element is having a same length. Okay, so just let me know the value of D2 bar and D3 bar. So 10.18, so this becomes 10.18 minus G into 1000/3. So what will be D3 bar? So 9.07. okay, so you can take higher decimal places, and finally we will just check it. 9.07 minus your gradient into 1000/3. So we'll try to verify this. So you can find out D4 bar. Has anyone calculated before bar? Okay, it is coming same value, that is 7.97 maybe. So this will get verified. So the process what we have done is correct. Okay. Now next challenge. So I will draw again same figure. So now I'm going to start the meshing. I'll be getting a 3 equal dimension. Okay, so I have all the values. Now my meshing will begin like this. So now this length is D2, or you can call this whole dimension length basically is D1, and this whole dimension length is D2, and this whole dimension length is D3. So basically what we are trying to convert is into mesh. Like this. Okay. So this is my mesh, what I am trying to have it. So here every circular cross section will be having a diameter D1, D2, D3 respectively. And now I know the top one is D1 bar, okay, and at this location is D2 bar. So for varying cross section, and for varying cross section diameter is D3 bar, and for varying cross section the bottommost diameter is D4 bar. So from this, it is an assumption that D1 is equal to D1 bar plus D2 bar by 2. So that is how I am going to get D1. D2 equal to D2 bar plus D3 bar by 2. Okay. And finally, D3 will be equal to D3 bar plus D4 bar by 2. Okay. So you can get these values. I'll try to write down 10.73, okay, then 9.62 and 8.52. Okay, so these are the values which I am getting it. Okay, so anybody could verify these values are correct or not? Now this is what is the problem. Okay, so that means now D1 is known to you, therefore so area of element 1 will be pi by 4 D1 square, area of element 2 will be pi by 4 D2 square, and area of third element will be pi by 4 D3 square. Okay, so I got the area A1, I got the area A2, I got the area A3, and I'm aware of each length is 1/3 L. This is also I'm aware of 1/3 L. Okay, and modulus of elasticity is also I'm aware of 200 GPa. The force which I am going to apply is also I am aware of, that is 5000 Newton. So now just let me know whether you can solve this problem or not. Okay, so you have to answer yes or no quickly. Come on, there are 62 students present. I'm getting few replies only. Okay, so let us consider, many of you are in a position because similar problem we have already solved. Okay, so that problem was horizontal, instead of that this problem is vertical, so there is no change at all. Okay, so instead of horizontal problem the problem has been vertical, and instead of two elements we have the three elements, nothing else. Okay, so then you can sort it, you can eliminate it, and finally you will be having a 3x3 matrix and which you can sort. So I just formulate it, so maybe I write stiffness matrix, maybe K1 is equal to, just to simplify, A1 E1 by L1. Okay, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Of course, connectivity table you have to prepare. I'm going to write 1 2 1 2. Okay, and let's call this whole parameter as A. Okay, similarly for K2, I'll be having parameter B. Similarly, I'll be having a parameter for K3 will be C. and my finally the global stiffness matrix will be of 4 by 4, that is A minus A minus A, A plus B minus B minus B, B plus C minus C minus C C, and rest all will be 0. So this will be 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, and then at the first it is fixed, therefore first row and first column will get eliminated, and what remains is the 3 by 3 system, because it has got the 4 nodes, degrees of freedom is 1, so therefore size of K will be 4 by 4, that is, we know how to calculate this, okay. So in this way, you can go ahead and solve this problem, so there is no issue, okay. So whatever this process we have done, this is either called as discretization, or in most common word, it is called as meshing. So now we know how to do the meshing, okay. Now we'll take the second problem, which is a square 10 by 10, and the bottom is again a square 5 by 5, okay. So again I draw the geometry. And here this is the square of 5 by 5, this is the square of 10 by 10, okay, 10 by 10. So task is, again it is a circular cross section, okay. So therefore find out this area at the top, okay. So I call this as area at the top, and I call this area at the bottom. So area at the top will be 100 mm square, area of the bottom will be 25 mm square, okay. Now from this I am supposed to get D1 bar, okay. So I just erase this. So this area basically is equal to, rather than this sign, I say equal to pi by 4 D1 bar whole square, and this will be pi by 4 D4 bar whole square, okay. So from this you can get the value of D1 bar, and from this you can get the value of D4 bar. So just let me know what is the value of D1 bar and D4 bar. So 11.28, I suppose the answer which I have put, 5.64, okay. So now I will divide this into equal length, okay, and all this in between dimension are D2 bar and D3 bar, and this is what I have to get. So first thing is to get the gradient, So gradient equal to d1 bar minus d4 bar by total length. So total length is 1000. Okay. So that will be 1.28 minus 5.64. Okay, divided by 1000. So in this way I got the gradient, and now I can get d2 bar is equal to d1 bar minus g into length of element 1. Okay, so d1 bar is 11.28. You could calculate this gradient. Length will be 1/1000. Okay. Similarly, you can calculate d3 bar. D3 bar will be d2 bar minus gradient into length of element 2. Okay. So please calculate this and just let me know the value d2 bar and d3 bar. So 9.04, 7.52. Okay, great. So now finally it is going to get converted into this shape. Okay, where here diameter is d1, d2, d3. Okay, so it is 9.40. Okay, thank you. Okay, so d1 equal to, so what is the assumption? d1 bar plus d2 bar by 2. And d2 will be equal to d2 bar plus d3 bar by 2, and d3 equal to d3 bar plus d4 bar by 2. In this way I am going to get all d's, and finally what, from d1 I will get the a1 as pi by 4 d1 square. A2 I will get pi by 4 d2 square, and A3 I will get pi by 4 d3 square. So I know force F, which is 5000 Newton. Okay, I know it is fixed at the top. Length is 1/3L and L is my 1000. Modulus of elasticity is 200 GPa. Now just let me know whether you can solve this problem or not. Okay, so again what we learn here in this case, meshing of square cross section. Okay, this is what we learn, and here we learn meshing of any cross section whose area is given to us. Okay, whose area is given to us. Now the third category is this. So top is 100, bottom is 50, and thickness is 5 mm. Okay, let's draw. So I'm just trying to draw this. Okay, so my top is 100 length and my bottom is 50. Okay, so I can call this as a W1 bar width, and I can call this as a W4 bar width. So first I will do something like this, equal length, and this is my W2 bar and this is my W3 bar. Okay, so first I will calculate gradient. Gradient will be equal to W1 bar minus W4 bar divided by total length, that is 1000. So this comes out to be 100 minus 50 divided by 1000. This is what is my gradient. How do I get W2 bar? That is W1 bar minus gradient into length of element 1, and that comes out to be 100 minus g, and length of element is 1 by 1000. Okay, similarly W3 bar will be equal to W2 bar minus gradient into length of element 2, that will be equal to, okay, so you just calculate this and let me know the value. Has anyone calculated? Sorry, this is not 1 by 1000. This is 1000 by actually 3, length of element. Okay, so 83.33. So did I write the same thing here? Okay, so this is also incorrect. So this has to be 1000 by 3. Okay, and anywhere else 1/3, 1000, 1000/3. So here I am writing correct. Okay. So here there was only problem. So it is 1000/3. So it should come 83.33, and then 66.68. Okay, that's fine. So you take at least 4 decimal places, and then W4 you can have a verification. Okay, fine, that's great. Now this has to be converted into this form. Okay, this will be W1, this will be W2, this will be W3. Okay, so how do I get W1? W1 equal to W1 bar plus W2 bar by 2, and W2 will be equal to W2 bar plus W3 bar by 2, then W3 is equal to W3 bar plus W4 bar by 2. Okay, so you can get this W's. And area at the top will be equal to W1 into thickness, so that will be W1 into, of course, 5 mm. So this I called as area 1. Area 2 will be equal to W2 into thickness, and area 3 equal to W3 into thickness. So I know area A1, I know area A2, I know area A3, I know force is 5000 newton, I know modulus of elasticity, that is 200 GPa. Okay, and fix at the top. So you can also solve this problem. Okay, so now this is meshing for thin cross section. Okay, so such type of problem is a part of FEA. Okay, so this additional process you have to do it before solving it. Okay, so just let me know whether you understood all the three meshing processes. Okay, so now next thing is penalty approach. Okay, this is what we have to study. Till date we have studied elimination approach. Okay, that is we eliminate rows and columns where displacement is known. Okay, but what is the trouble with this? Very difficult to write the program. Okay, because here in this case first and last will be eliminated. In some complex problem, okay, maybe something like this could have any complex structure, okay, and then you label the node number, okay, and this is fixed, and then we have to go for elimination, maybe 1 2 3 4. So haphazardly we might be eliminating this, we might be eliminating this, we might be eliminating this. So in this way we keeps on doing it, okay, and finally whatever the matrix we get and we try to solve it, okay, and we when we go back, what is my original matrix? So we'll become in a lost space, okay, as far as programming is concerned, because once we eliminated or deleted, then getting back is very challenging job, okay, and this elimination is challenging. So to overcome this approach, okay, the other approach is the penalty approach. So what we do basically here, we penalize the system, we penalize the system, and then we use the elimination approach, okay. So we'll quickly go through what we are going to do right now. So I'll just explain what is the penalizing, and then later on I'll explain you how to use the elimination again after penalizing and what advantage we get it, okay. So I draw horizontal problem instead of vertical to save the space. So if this is my problem, so I just use two system, okay, so two elements, and let us say force I am applying here, and let us say it is fixed at this location, okay. So this is element 1, this is element 2, this is my node number 1, this is my node number 2, and this is my node number 3, and I am applying a force here. So normal procedure of elimination we are aware of. Now in penalty approach, what we do, we remove this fixed support and put it somewhere else and add additional material having stiffness C, and then we have our system, okay. So what we are doing with the introducing this is penalizing the system, okay, and then we will be using a elimination. So this is my force. So I introduce an additional spring having a stiffness C. Now the C is very large, okay, as compared with element 1 and 2. Okay, of course, so as compared with stiffness of element 1 and 2. So ideally there is no change. So by adding this condition, the system remains the same, okay. So ideally we are introducing a stiff some additional spring of very large stiffness, okay. So therefore these two system are we say they are very equal to each other, okay. So there is a small minor change might be, but they are very similar, okay. Now what this additional things is providing, additional whatever the C we are introducing, that is help is going to help us to write a program in more simplified way. So you don't have to take a lot of effort or lot complex algorithm to code, and then of course memory size will be increased, that is the later part, but still it the life becomes easier, and we can easily write a code, create the stiffness matrix, and then we can solve it, okay. So tomorrow or maybe in the next lecture we are going to think about this what is this penalty approach, and then we are going to introduce a temperature problem and we'll try to solve additional temperature based problem. Okay, so thank you.